This video tutorial is provided by the College of Graduate Studies at UCF. In this video, I will review the requirements for each page of Frontmatter content and provide an example of properly formatted content using the sample ETD. This file is available on the College of Graduate Studies website. One of the most user-friendly requirements of UCF ETDs is the presence of bookmarks in the PDF document. You can see from the bar on the left that a reader is able to view and link to any section in the document without having to scroll up to the table of contents each time. Please note that subheadings are nested under section headings, and these headings are auto-generated by Adobe Acrobat from the use of Microsoft Word styles. In later videos, I will demonstrate how to use styles throughout your document. For now, I'll begin with the title page. The title page is the only page that must be single-spaced. If you are using APA or another style manual that requires a header, UCF requirements overrule this style. There should not be any content in the header or footer of this page. This page is the only unnumbered page in the document. The title of the document must be typed in all caps. The author's name should also appear in all caps without any degree abbreviations after the name. Previous degrees should be placed underneath the author's name, typed in title caps, with only the first letter of each major word capitalized. The text block with all degree information from the university must follow this order with the appropriate information. If your program is part of a school within the university, such as the School of Accounting or School of Communication, include this information after the type of degree. Only doctoral students are required to list their major professor. This information is optional for master's students. If you list a major professor, do not include any titles. This information should be placed 1 inch below the graduation date. The copyright page is optional, but is strongly recommended. Regardless of whether or not you register your work, including a copyright page can help protect your work. You will retain the copyright regardless of whether a copyright page is included or not. If you include this page, be sure that the information is centered vertically and horizontally. Insert the copyright symbol and include the year and your name. If this page is included, page numbering will begin on the copyright page. Frontmatter sections use Roman numerals for page numbers. If the copyright page is not included, page numbering will start with the abstract. If the copyright page is not present, the abstract will be the second page of your document. It is required that you have an abstract page in your document. The abstract is a scholarly summary of your research. While references may appear in the abstract if necessary, figures and tables are not allowed. Text must be double-spaced, with the abstract heading centered at the top of the page. If your abstract requires more than one page, do not repeat the heading or use the word continued. This section will also receive a PDF bookmark. I'll show you how to apply the pre-content heading style in order to generate the bookmark in a later video. The dedication page is optional. Whereas the acknowledgements section contains formal thanks to funding organizations, major professors, and other contributors, the dedication is an informal, personal section wherein the author can place a statement of gratitude toward family, friends, and others. This text must be centered vertically on the page without a heading. It does not receive a PDF bookmark. The acknowledgements page is optional. If the author wishes to extend thanks or recognition to any funding organizations, mentors, professors, or formal organizations, it may be done here. If the author has included any pre-published material, they may also name specific portions of the thesis or dissertation that have been reprinted and acknowledge the publishers of these portions. This section requires a centered heading along the top margin and will also receive a PDF bookmark if used. I'll show you how to apply the pre-content heading style to generate this bookmark in a later video. The table of contents should have a chapter heading centered at the top of the page. When you generate the actual table of contents, it should include all sections following the table of contents, but not including its own header. Neither the sections prior nor the heading of the page should appear in the table of contents. All entries should be linked to where they appear in the document. I'll show you how to accomplish this in the video tutorial for the table of contents. A list of figures is required if any figures are used within the document. The heading for list of figures should be centered at the top of the page in all caps. The term figure also applies to any graphics, photos, charts, maps, or other visual representations that are not in table form. The list of figures must contain the full figure title with the label and number, and each entry must link to the corresponding figure in the text. The list of figures must also contain any figures that are included in an appendix. If your list of figures continues to the next page, do not repeat the header or use the word continued for the following page. Although the list of figures is a Frontmatter section, it should be listed within the table of contents as it follows the table of contents page. A list of tables is required if any tables are used within the document. The heading for this page should be typed in all caps and centered at the top of the page. The list of tables must contain the label, number, and full title for each table, and link to its location in the document, including tables within an appendix. If the list of tables continues to the next page, do not repeat the header or use the word continued for the following page. Although the list of tables is a Frontmatter section, it should be listed within the table of contents as it follows the table of contents page. As you can see, the sample ETD includes a couple of sections that are considered to be optional for UCF ETD. In this chart, you can see which sections are required and which sections are optional. This concludes the video tutorial for Frontmatter sections. For more information, view the thesis and dissertation manual available on the College of Graduate Studies website. In the next video, I will discuss body content sections.